Hello, my name is Jose Martin Garcia and I'm going to present some of the new functions for geography in version 11, as well as extensions to the functionality already present in version 10. There are many additions and extensions that can be separated in three big groups: mapping and geovisualization of data, geocomputation, and geodata. Let me start by recalling two of the fundamental geo functions. Geoposition stores latitude and longitude data, either for a single point or for an array of points. Then, geographic is the main function for maps, of an area, or also adding geoprimitives, like this red polygon or the blue curve joining two locations. Version 11 includes dynamic geographic, which adds zooming and panning to maps. We can zoom in and change the region of interest. The language of geographic has been extended with new background styles. For example, we can show country borders, we have new satellite tiles for the Earth, or even for the Moon and other planets, in this case Mars. The new option GeoServer allows you to connect to many other tile servers, in this case an OpenStreetMap server. Another fundamental new function is GeoHistogram, which provides flexible visualization of histograms over the Earth. In this example, we take the positions of the breweries in the contiguous US, we can plot them using geographic as points, and we can create a geohistogram, in this case using a rectangular grid of squares of 200 km side. Show now in version 11 allows merging any two maps, and also modifying the options, in this case adding geogrid lines. Another fundamental ingredient of mapping is the choice of geoprojection, say the Mercator projection. Version 11 contains a huge list of projections, almost 5 times the number of projections in version 10. We also now have information about those projections and their classifications. This is a collage of graticules, the sets of lines of constant latitude and longitude for the whole world, and we see the large variety of shapes associated to these projections. These are other two examples showing this variety of shapes. Let us now talk about geocomputation. We have new functions to compute lengths of curves on the surface of the Earth, as well as functions to compute areas of geopolygons. These are fast and precise functions, assuming an ellipsoidal model of the Earth. In this example, we start with the landing points for the Southern Cross Submarine Communication Cable. These are 9 landing points. This is an approximation to that cable, assuming a geodesic segment between consecutive landing points. This is a map of the cable over the Pacific. This is the total length of the cable, and this is the total area enclosed by the cable. Version 11 also adds new functions to compute travel instructions between two or more locations by driving, biking, or walking. For example, drive from Seattle to New Orleans going through Las Vegas. This object contains much information about the trip. For example, this is the estimation of the total travel time, assuming continuous driving. This is the estimation of the total travel distance. This is a map in which we can see how precise the instructions are. And this is finally the grid of maneuvers for that trip. Version 11 has added much geodata and has also improved the existing data. For example, we now have polygon data for historical countries, empires, etc. This map shows the Roman Empire at its maximal extension. We also have geophysics data. For example, geomagnetic model data provides the information about the magnetic field of the Earth. Note that it returns results using quantity array, which is a very efficient representation of arrays of quantities with units. The visualization functions can handle those quantity arrays as they would handle any other array. This is a map representing the magnitude of the magnetic field over the Earth. We also have geogravity model data with information about the gravitational field of the Earth and also returning quantity array results. This is a map showing the variability of the magnitude of the gravitational field over the Earth. And we also have information about the geoid in geoelevation data. The geoid is the surface used to define zero elevation. For those of you interested in the new geo functionality, we recommend accessing the extensive documentation on the new functions. You can go to the individual reference pages, like that of GeoHistogram, you can go to the new tutorial on the geo functionality, or you can visit the three web pages containing many examples on the different things you can do with the new functions for geography in version 11. Thank you very much for your attention.